Carnivorous apes or monkeys are a relatively common trope in speculative evolution, often descended from baboons, but this concept is not limited to fiction. Many primates are omnivores, and the tarsier is entirely carnivorous. Chimpanzees hunt bush babies and sadly even cannibalize young chimps during their wars. Humans are apes, and plenty of scientists think we hunted many ancient megafauna to extinction, although that was obviously with tools. However, there aren't any fully carnivorous great apes, being the big, tailless primates, chimps, bonobos, gorillas, orangutans, and us humans. But what if some apes did have lifestyles centered around chasing down or ambushing prey? Well, let's speculate. First, apes would need a reason to become carnivorous, and an environment where it's possible. The easiest way for something to evolve is for a niche, or role in the ecosystem, to be empty. As animals reproduce and need more food, some individuals may start filling that niche if possible. So, let's take all the big carnivores out of an environment, a region with a lot of primates and herbivorous mammals, but no predators. Chimpanzees are already omnivorous, so they'd be a good candidate to fill this empty niche. It would likely begin with chimps becoming opportunistic hunters, catching sick or elderly animals, and anything they can catch off guard. Four big parts of carnivory are finding, catching, subduing, and finally eating prey. There are various strategies a carnivorous chimp could take to do these, but let's say our chimp split into two groups: pursuit hunters and ambush hunters. First of all, the pursuit-hunting chimps would likely be pack hunters, thanks to primates' social structures, using numbers and intelligence to surround, corral, and outsmart their prey, and take down bigger animals in groups. Chimps aren't good at running for long periods of time. Their muscle fibers are better for powerful, rapid movements, so they might evolve more slow-twitch muscles like humans. These chimps would look less muscular and be physically less strong, but they could run after prey without easily tiring, and perhaps even engage in endurance hunting, a form of pursuit hunting where the prey are taken down by indirect means like exhaustion. Assuming these chimps aren't climbing or using tools, they might stop knuckle walking and instead walk with their palms flat on the ground. Since they're hunting large prey on the ground, they wouldn't need to climb, so they might have shorter arms and longer bodies for a faster gait. While not necessarily the case, these chimps might evolve digitigrade walking, which means walking on their toes as opposed to plantigrade walking, walking with the foot flat on the ground. This would allow for faster movement. It's worth mentioning that chimps probably couldn't evolve to be bipedal. Contrary to the March of Progress image, humans and chimps are now believed to have branched off separately from a gibbon-like ancestor that wasn't fully quadrupedal or bipedal, rather than an awkward transition from knuckle-walking to walking bipedally. I am leaving out a lot of context and evidence, so there'll be a link to a great video by Stefan Milo in the description. Check it out if you're interested. Point is, no bipedal chimps. These chimps' teeth would likely sharpen for delivering a killing bite, since their hands would be weaker after increasing endurance. Their guts would also likely change, as they adapt to digesting and surviving off only meat. Now that we've designed pursuit-hunting chimps, let's speculate about the ambush hunters. Like I said before, chimps have more slow-twitch muscles, which are not as bad for this strategy, allowing them to move in fast bursts and deliver devastating blows. Thus, an ambush-hunting chimp could probably keep a more traditional ape-like body plan. Not that they wouldn't change anything, since ambush-hunting still usually involves a short burst of speed, but perhaps these chimps would even keep their hands to grab prey, although they might need them to walk on while running. They'd likely be solitary to hide more easily, and perhaps grow a lot bigger than the pursuit hunters. Speaking of which, their biggest enemies could be the pursuit-hunting chimps, which might mob them in greater numbers to steal their kills. So perhaps they could still climb, assuming they don't get too big to do so. This would allow them to drag their meals into the trees like leopards, where nothing can get to them. The other strategy would be getting big enough to use their incredible size and strength to fight off a whole pack. It's possible that the pursuit hunters would have evolved from early ambush hunters as an intermediary step, and the two techniques would likely often be mixed. Thanks for watching! What do you think carnivorous chimps would be like? Let me know down in the comments, along with anything I got wrong or missed. This video had a focus on large carnivores. How about you theorize on what a baboon-sized predator might be like? Oh wait, they're already omnivores. Guess that's why they're always evolving into lions in Spec Evo. Anyway, please subscribe if you've enjoyed the video. It's free, helps out a bunch, and you can always change your mind later. Consider checking out my Patreon if you're in a position to do so. It's a great way to support the channel, although I don't really have any exclusive content on there at the moment, and watching these videos is certainly enough. I'll also be linking a video by Unnatural History Channel on the subject of carnivorous primates in the description, and it's probably on the screen right now. Anyway, thanks for watching, have a great day, and I'll see you next time!